Today, let's create the velvet material together. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, we'll create the velvet material that you can use in your interior visualizations. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, let's start. We'll use this polygon material as the base. I put the link below the video to this. You can see these nice details here that imitate the materials working differently in different directions. Okay, let's jump to 3ds Max. By the way, the video showing creating the velvet material is part of our advanced interior training. If you would like to learn more about it, I put the link to it in the corner and in the description below the video. Okay, let's start interactive rendering and we'll start working on materials. Let's drag and drop a couple of maps to the material editor. I will use the normal bump texture, displacement map, ambient occlusion texture, and this diffuse map. Let's organize them in the editor. We can start from the normal texture. Add the normal corona map to the editor. Flip green and add gamma to input. These options are suggested by Polygon. You don't have to use them if you are using different maps. And plug a bump map into the additional bump slot. We're starting something. It's nice. I'll unplug the corona material map for a moment and I'll test the displacement. It's too strong. I reduce the max level value. And now, let's test it all together. Nice! We have great details visible. Now let's work on the base color. Use Corona Mix and plug the AO map into the top slot and the color map to the bottom slot. I will make the preview bigger so you can see what's going on. Choose Multiply and plug everything into the base color slot. This way, we put the darker diffuse texture using the black parts of ambient occlusion. As a result, we achieve more details. Okay, now I will adjust the color of the velvet material as I want it to be reddish. Use the color correction map and adjust the values. Quick tip! If you hold Ctrl on your keyboard and place the map on the line, you can quickly plug the map in between connected nodes. I think that the effect of this texture is a bit too strong, so I will use the mix map to make it more subtle. Let's set up the corona color and adjust the mix amount. We can pick the color from the color correction node. Value 50 means that the map are equally strong, so we have 50% of the map and 50% of the color. Okay, we have the base done, now let's work on the sheen layer. It helps to render soft microfiber fabrics like velvet, satin and silk. In the past, we had to add a follow-up map to do this, but now it's much more simplified. Amount controls how strong the effect is. We can start with the value equal to 1. And I will make it a bit darker color. And let's test different roughness values. Low roughness keeps the specular highlights at the grazing angle, and as it increases, the sheen reflection dominates. I think 0.4 works nice. Now let's adjust the amount as the effect is too strong. 0.4 looks good. Okay, great. I will adjust the IUR value. 1.24 is the value Corona uses in their presets, so I will go with that. And now, let's adjust the roughness value. Value 0 means that the material is not rough at all, so very reflective. Value 1 is the opposite. I want my material to be just a bit reflective. 0.9 looks nice. Actually, I think we can work a bit more on the sheen effect. I will plug the Corona color into the sheen color slot and I will adjust the map amount so it will have a little bit more color. Let's start with the value 20. It means the map will have 20% opacity. Nice! The overall color is too dark. I will use a color correction map to brighten everything up. Awesome, but I will change the color of the sheen to something more pinkish. And maybe I will increase the effect. Now there is another important thing when we create materials like this one, and this is the lighting. If you want to create the material that looks amazing and is realistic, it needs to be nicely lit. Let me show you what I mean. For instance, I will increase the intensity of the light to enhance the sheen effect. Also, I will add one more light from the top. But this one will be warmer and disc shape. I will increase directionality so the light is less soft and focus more directly on the sofa. Always test different positions to find the best one. It doesn't necessarily have to be in the place where the lights in real life are. It's to make your material look more realistic. Okay, this is our final result. If you would like to learn more cool things like this, and you would like to learn our way of approaching bigger projects like this one, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced interior training. It includes more than 60 lessons. Definitely look into it if you want to create images like this. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye!